testing Autopilot in the fog for the first time. In fact, it actually looks surprisingly clearer on camera than it does in real, by the naked eye, what you'll be able to tell as we pass these cars. And in fact, I just drove down this road before the fog rolled in the dark, and Autopilot actually had some problems and had a lot of disappearing lane markers. However, in the fog, for some reason, it seems to be doing a better job. In fact, I have not had to steer or touch the steering wheel at all in about, I'd say, 15 minutes. And you can see how foggy it is just by seeing the other car's headlights. I mean, it's pretty foggy now. And looks like I'll finally have to take over. There is a roundabout. And while I did train the car to do roundabouts at low speeds, extremely low speeds, I'm talking about the minimum of 18, it's not reliable and I'm not going to risk it. Take over once again, bring her back up to 55. And it's scanning for lines. It's having trouble reacquiring the lines. Eyes are a little more faded over here. There we go. Autopilot engaged. I got one hand with the wheel just to be on the safe side. But the fog's clearing up a bit. It was rather impressive how the Autopilot handled the fog situation better. My ideal or reasoning is potentially that since the fog is kind of drowning out all surrounding objects, pretty much kind of like, think of it like masking other objects around. Now, since the road paint stands out considerably more, I'm guesstimating that it's able to differentiate between the other objects then and the lines better because of that. And the car is deciding to follow the right lane, which is actually a turning lane. Let's see if it will, and wouldn't you know it, move right back over. Not bad. Not bad at all. 35 mile an hour speed limit. Oh, gotta slow down again. In fact, the car is actually picking up the speed limit signs before I even see them now. And the paint on those speed limit signs is very reflective, and we had some wandering there, so I took over. This kind of weather is not something that you mess around in. 25 mile an hour speed limit, and there's an officer up ahead. So, okay. Let's see if we can lock onto the car in front of us. The car sees it. Autopilot sees the vehicle in front of us. It's not giving me the option to lock on, and it knows there's lines there, but it's having trouble now locking onto those. Well, I'll have to brake manually now because there's a stoplight and that car's turning. Either way, very impressive with the fog, how it managed to take over and maintain those lines. Actually, extremely impressive. And it was pretty thick fog, and surprisingly also, my camera was able to cut through the fog better than I could see with the naked eye. Well, I have glasses on, but better than I could see with my regular eyes. Okay, that squad car is really reflecting, and car's having a little trouble now, and that's it. I'm going to put the phone down now. Smile, cheese.